I'm here at what must be the best preserved mining history in North America, the historic copper district of Keweenaw Point in the state of Michigan. The remains of the Quincy Mine Smelter sit on the shores of Portage Lake in Hancock. 10.5 billion pounds of copper have been produced by all the Keweenaw mines from 1844 to 1968. Now that's a motherload. Follow me while I explore the Keweenaw with its mining ruins, headframes, and incredible examples of float copper. Don't forget, check out my ebook, Lake Superior, Above and Below Ground. Here's an excellent example of the stone ruins and ornate cornerstones made of red sandstone. The stonemasons of the day must have been quite talented. Quite nice. On location at the Keweenaw National Historic Park, this excellent example of float copper with this green patina weighing in at a total of 9,392 pounds. That's incredible. Copper has a hardness of 3 with a specific gravity of 8.9. 1 cubic foot of copper would weigh 551 pounds. So you see where that 9,000 pounds is coming from. Very impressive indeed. I'm going to have a closer look at this massive 250 foot brick constructed smokestack. What a beautiful piece of mining history, craftsmanship, with its buttress-like reinforced walls. Very impressive. The year was 1908, and all over the Keweenaw, mansions were being built by wealthy copper mine owners. Here in Laurium, the largest and most opulent of all, was just being completed. Built for Thomas H. Hostin, owner of the Calumet and Arizona Mining Company. No expense was spared in the building of this 13,000 square foot, 45 room mansion. The exquisite features include a silver leaf ceiling, elephantide wall coverings, stained glass windows, and tiled fireplaces. These and many more original features still are in the mansion. Also listed by Forbes magazine as a top 10 bed and breakfast. Very impressive indeed. On location today at Calumet downtown, I've come across a vendor at the street side selling copper. Some excellent examples from area mines such as the Baltic, the Central, Rhode Island. Very nice examples here, cleaned up quite nicely. It has hundreds of samples here at this location, but these are the larger ones, ranging in price from $10 to $200. Built in 1918, this house was cost $370,000 to build. As you can see, these black slots in front of the building here, that's where the cables exited the building and continued up behind me some distance to the headframes. Located here at the side of the highway at the Quincy Mine is this very large piece of copper, beautiful green patina. I'm going to have a closer look and take a measurement of it. Approximately 11 feet long.
4 feet high. 1 cubic foot of copper weighs 551 pounds. I would estimate this to be 6,000 pounds. Nice ring.
I'm on location in the cavernous building of the Nordberg steam hoist, a huge building housing a huge steam-powered hoist. The large drum, as you can see, is where the steel cables were attached to, which ran outside through the building, through slots, up to the head frame. This is the world's largest steam hoist. Very impressive. Like a work of art in this huge building. Located here in the old ruin is a very heavy-duty blower. Embossed on it, it reads, "For cupola furnaces and forges. B.F. Stravant, Massachusetts. Number 6. Nice piece of history mounted up on a platform or what may have been the second floor at one time. And to the right, some belt-driven flywheels. Nice history.